What's up, everybody? This is UPW superstar Chris Caden, and you're watching The Scott Richards Show.
So I collapse, I'm spilling these raps, long as you fill them. To the day that I drop, you'll never say that I'm not killing them. Cause when I am not, then I'ma stop pinning them. And I...
The following productions is the Scott Richardson's podcast.
And what is going on, everybody? Welcome to the Scott Richards Show. I am your host, the Scott Richards. This is episode one of a new series I am starting called the Scott Richards Podcast. And there's a dog in the background if you guys are wondering what that is. Rip. And today, we're going to talk about some wrestling, some rap, and other topics. And I have two guests here today. One of my first guests is a man. A sexy beast. He was back in the EBW days. This man won the first and only EBW World Rumble match. My man, the Icon.
What's going on, everybody?
And right here, we got my other boy. He's never been on the YouTube channel. Well, yes, you have. You were in my vlog.
Yeah,
Is your boy, Donnie.
I'm going to be in one of the matches, too, but it kind of got deleted and all that.
Yeah, because YouTube is a rip.
Yeah.
YouTube don't like me. Is your boy, Donnie, a.k.a.
Little Poppy, you know, I'm about to... You know, I'm about to rap, bro. I'm about to make it out.
Yeah, here he's coming up, rapper. Yeah. So, can I call you by your real name?
You can call me Chris Cello. I prefer cello.
And that dude in the background is another sexy beast. So we got your boy Icon, aka Chris. So what have you been up to?
You know, nothing much. A few months back, I sadly fractured my foot. So you know, the road to recovery has been tough. It's been something that I don't wish upon anybody else. But I feel like I'm back now. I'm back on my feet, and I'm looking to break out, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. All right, and I know that you currently do backyard wrestling, and what's the backyard wrestling business you work with?
RSVW. If you are a fan of backyard wrestling or any wrestling period, I do recommend checking us out.
I'll leave a link in the description below.
Good looks.
And also your YouTube channel. You want to shout that out real quick?
I'd rather shout out my Instagram, you know what I'm saying? Go follow me on Instagram, @acello, you know what I'm saying? Up and coming.
Alright, and Little Papa, what have you been up to?
You know, chilling, just taking care of day by day, you know, school shit, you know.
Yeah, we got senior year. You just turned 18 not that long ago.
Yeah.
And also, your boy, me, D. Scott Richards, got accepted to GCC, baby. And I just want to give a little quick shout out. If you are a fan of pro wrestling and you live in Brockport, Rochester, anywhere near that, go check out UPW's next event. UPW presents Valentine's Day Massacre February 8th at the Brockport's Elks Lodge. Regular seats are $18 at the door, $20 for front row. And if you are looking for pre-sale tickets are going for regular seats, $15. And I believe that is when Scott Richards will be making his debut. Probably going to get my booty spanked. I'm gonna get my ass whooped. Yo, you better chill with that. And, yeah, so, also I train at Flower City Wrestling Academy. Central July is probably one of the best wrestling schools, not just in New York State, probably in the entire world. Incredible people. And it's been one of my favorite things in life right now. So, let's talk about the Royal Rumble. I know Lil Papa don't watch the Royal Rumble. You don't watch wrestling. But we'll get in your topic after this. But Icon over here, you want to talk about the Royal Rumble, baby?
Of course.
Cause the Royal Rumble is tomorrow, baby.
I'm really hyped. To be honest, I feel like this is going to be a really good show. You know, I've been watching wrestling my whole life. Took a little break from the 2016 to 2017. It was kind of ass, but
yeah.
I really feel like my predictions here: Brock Lesnar comes on number one. Matt Riddle comes on number two. I don't really got any predictions for the other people. I do feel like Drew McIntyre is going to win it. I feel like the last three people are going to be Brock Lesnar, Seth Rollins, and Drew McIntyre. And then Drew McIntyre eliminates both. And, yeah, I got Drew McIntyre winning it.
Yeah. I actually agree with you. Drew McIntyre is probably the best pick to win the Royal Rumble. If you don't pick Drew McIntyre to win this year's Royal Rumble, then you are legally blind. So let's also talk about some other matches. We got The Fiend, Bray Wyatt, defending the Universal Championship in a strap match, I think. I thought it was a strap-on match. I'm like, what The Fiend up to? He's going against Daniel Bryan, and I got my money on The Fiend. Yeah, what about you?
I'll put $100 on The Fiend. Like, I don't think it's up for debate. The Fiend is not ready to lose his championship yet, in my opinion.
Yeah, we also got heel Bayley, which is red hot right now. We got Bayley defending her SmackDown Women's Championship because Lacey Evans. Lacey Evans is a good face, but I don't know. Something about Bayley being champion is too good right now, and I think Bayley is going to retain her championship.
This is going to surprise you. I got my money on Lacey Evans.
Oh, hell no. Why?
I really do, because I feel like they're building it up. Like, the Bayley disrespecting her kid and everything, like, I don't feel like WWE is going to make Lacey Evans disappoint her kid. And if they do, if Bayley wins, it's going to be with the help of Sasha Banks. Let's be real.
Speaking of Sasha Banks, let's talk about the women's Royal Rumble match. And a lot of people are saying, oh, Ronda Rousey's going to come back, or Shayna Baszler's going to debut. You know who I'm betting to win the women's Royal Rumble, Icon?
Who's that?
Sasha Banks. She's winning the Rumble. She's going to turn face Bayley at Mania. They're going to have an iconic match at WrestleMania for the SmackDown Women's title. What about you? Who do you think's winning the Women's Royal Rumble this year?
I feel like it's all set in stone. I mean, the end of Survivor Series is just a teaser of what's going to happen at WrestleMania. That's Shayna Baszler versus Becky Lynch. I got Shayna Baszler winning it.
You sound like everybody else. God damn it. What else we got? Oh, we got Becky Lynch defending the Raw Women's Championship against Asuka in a rematch from last year's Royal Rumble. And we all know who's going over. It's going to be Becky Lynch retaining the Raw Women's title.
Without a doubt.
Yeah. You can join in if you want. Do you want to? All right, we got some jackass in the background. We also... What else we got? Oh, we got Shorty G, a.k.a. Chad Gable, versus Sheamus.
I said I like the chicken.
Oh, you like the chicken? Joining in our podcast is another former EBW superstar. He's currently at RSPW. It is the dashing one, the most sexiest man besides Icon. And I'm not gay, I'm just curious.
What?
Day Young.
What's goody?
What's goody? Do you want to join in too? Okay, no. All right, since you're here, Day Young, what have you been up to?
Tired. But I just woke up, but hey. So, like, I was hearing this when I was laying down and shit. So, like, I'm sorry. I got sniffles. My bad.
Yeah, he a bitch.
What?
hey, ow, fucker. Day Young, who's your pick to win the men's Royal Rumble this year?
Drew McIntyre.
Yeah, all right, so all three of us, Sam McIntyre, Lil Papa don't watch Rumble.
I mean, he got Drew McIntyre.
Yeah. Yeah, he the cool guy.
I just don't find it entertaining. I like basketball more.
Yeah, basketball and rap.
Speaking of basketball, he just got his ass whooped in 2K, 106-36.
Wow, yeah, that's 70-point
blowout.
Damn.
Yeah, bro, I'm trying. I know.
No, he's still good.
I don't really.
Hey, you're better than me. I can't do shit.
I just don't play on PS4. I play Xbox more.
Alright. Yo, Day Young. Who's winning the Women's Royal Rumble?
My picks for Raw is Charlotte for the LOLs. My pick for SmackDown is Sasha Banks.
Yeah.
My pick for NXT is Shayna Baszler.
Oh, God. Can you imagine if Lana won the Royal Rumble?
Spit on that bitch.
I'd much rather have Liv Morgan win it over that bitch.
Oh my god, yo, Liv Morgan, I don't know what they're doing, but she had that NWO attire last week. Come on, that looked like NWO. But, so we also talked about Lacey Evans versus Bayley, and Becky versus Asuka. We actually were just talking about that just now. So I said Becky gonna beat Asuka. What do you guys think?
I got Becky. I just personally, I hate Asuka's character.
What?
Where she's doing
I got Asuka.
Where she can't speak English, that shit, like, really
pissed. Oh, you racist motherfucker.
That green mist shit, that shit's annoying. It was cool the first time she used it, but now she's using that way too much. I personally think Asuka's just horrible.
Oof. So who'd you say you got there, Young?
I got Asuka.
You got Asuka? You know she's like one half of the women's tag team champions, which the titles mean nothing right now. Yeah. In my opinion, they mean nothing.
Titles, they ruined our titles. It was too early to bring in a tag team.
Alright. Yeah. There's also Shorty G or Chad Gable versus Sheamus. Sheamus is going to murder.
That's going to be a spot.
Yeah. What do you think?
Sheamus.
Yeah, Sheamus. Is there any other matches?
I think the Intercontinental Champion.
Shinsuke Nakamura versus Braun Strowman.
I got Shinsuke.
Are they real? Is that real? Is that a real thing?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Roman versus Corbin.
Oh, I haven't watched SmackDown because it's so bad. Yeah, the only thing I like is The Fiend and John Morrison.
Yeah.
Can we talk about that for a minute? What do you guys think about John Morrison's return?
Here's the thing. If they build it up to be a John Morrison and Miz feud at WrestleMania, I'd be down with that. But if they don't, I don't know what's the point of bringing him back.
Yeah. And then how they return him was really weird.
They spoiled it, man.
Yeah. Some people think this is a hot topic. CM Punk or Edge, or maybe both, will be in this year's Royal Rumble. I personally think that's not even going to happen.
If one of those were to be returned, that's Edge. I don't think CM Punk's going to return, and if he does, cool, I'm not going to be very hyped because, to be honest, I wasn't really a big fan of CM Punk. I mean, I get the hype around him, but it's like, yeah, CM Punk was good, but let's be honest. All he really did was cut really good promos and get bailed out by Paul Heyman for most of his title reign. And when he went up against the real competitor like Lesnar, he got anally fucked.
Ooh.
But
wow.
CM Punk's cool and all, but would I be overly hyped if he came back? No, I wouldn't. I'm sorry to say. CM Punk's cool, but
all right. What do you think, Rip? What do you think, Dae Young?
What?
If Edge or CM Punk came back. I actually personally think that Jeff Hardy's coming back.
Yeah, the Velveteen is my pick to come back.
Jeff Hardy, for that one, is kind of hard right now because they said he might go back to court and he might not make it to the Royal Rumble or WrestleMania for that matter. So that kind of going to fucking suck because he have a DUI again.
Yeah, and he's got a lot of demons.
I know.
Yeah, man, we all battle those.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. For Edge and CM Punk return, I think I want Edge to return. I don't know if he's in.
And just think, over a decade ago, he won the Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
I really want Edge to return because it's been like a hot minute. And CM Punk, I don't know. Like, I think half of the time, you know when you like see those like, oh, CM Punk's gonna return or like those
fucking happens spoilers, every single year.
And like, it doesn't happen.
Yeah.
It just kills the hype and nobody gets interested anymore. So like I don't see him returning anytime soon, to be honest.
Yeah.
This week man probably won't even let him be near our WWE rank at this point.
Oof.
Because
he exposed
a WrestleMania match card that was supposed to happen.
Dude, do you really believe that? I don't think that's true. Alright, we're going to talk about one more wrestling topic, and then we're going to change the topic a little bit. I know this is going to be real sensitive to some people in this room. Let's talk about Tessa Blanchard. What'd you just say? So you guys, does anyone who know who Tessa Blanchard is?
Yeah.
What's your opinion? If some people don't know...
About the racist incident?
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, I may have...
Oh, you heard about that?
Yeah, I saw...
It was all over fucking Twitter.
Oh my god.
I saw that shit, too. But I just... Because I saw the video of it.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
So... Are you really watching you winning at UFC?
Yes, sir.
Oh my god, you mark. So what happened was, I guess she put out a tweet about women wrestling sticking together, and I guess everybody went after that ass. Even Chelsea Green from NXT, some other women from like NWA, like other women from Impact, even some chicks from NXT UK. And it's crazy. And even me and him. And I guess she did some racist stuff in, like, what, Japan, I think? What does she do? Do you remember?
I think she spit on a black woman.
So yeah, and, like, dropped the N-word.
Yeah.
Did she call her... I can't say it. But
you could say it. You,
the A or the ER? Did she call her the ER or the A?
I think ER. I'm not sure.
Yeah, fuck that bitch.
Yeah.
No.
If she did say that, that's kind of disrespectful. But, like, if the woman knew about this, then why didn't they speak on it earlier? That's my question. Because it just came out all of a sudden.
It was after Blanchett.
Yeah, after she was going after the TNA World Heavyweight Championship, faced to Sami Callihan.
Yo, I'm actually not a fan of Sami Callihan. I don't know. Something about his character I just don't like. I do love Impact, though. Don't get me wrong. Ace Austin is really good.
Austin Aries?
No, Ace Austin.
Oh.
He's a new guy in Impact. He's really good. But I know what she did is messed up, but I think it's awesome that she's now the Impact World Heavyweight Champion. But a lot of people are still pissed off about it. Like, a lot. But you gotta think about, I think about it in Impact shoes. They've been building that feud with her and Sami Callihan, or her just being in the males divisions for a whole year. Because after she, last year after she won the Knockout Women's title, she started wrestling the guys, and then she started a little feud with Sami Callihan, and then it continued with her trying to reach that title, and then she finally did it, and now she's world champion. People are pissed.
I honestly don't know how to feel about it at this point.
It's like Hulk Hogan all over again.
Yeah, basically.
But, we're gonna take a break from wrestling for a little bit. We're gonna talk about some rap. We're gonna ask everyone in this room who's their favorite rapper and why. If you got more than one, that is okay. Lil Papa, you can go first.
Man, I listen to a lot of rap shit.
I know you don't got like not one favorite, but who do you like? Name some rappers you like.
I fuck with Trippie Redd, dude. Gets me like that man is good. Who's another good one? Like, Wi-Fi's Funeral, I fuck with that dude heavy, because that man can spit over some, like dark-type beats and all that. And, of course, you know, me, your boy, because, you
Little Popple.
Yeah, because,
You could spit some bars, right?
Yeah.
Alright, what about you, Icon? What rappers you like?
I'm gonna name my all-time favorite and then some of my favorites right now. My all-time favorite, hands down, is J. Cole.
J. Cole is good.
I think he's the best rapper of all time, lyrically.
Yeah. I don't agree with that.
And then my favorite rappers right now, gotta go with Moneybagg Yo.
Moneybagg Yo's fire. I fuck with that, dude.
I think he dropped the hottest album out.
Yeah,
the
that...
hottest album out right now.
Yeah, that was good. I fuck with that album.
You know, my second favorite rapper, I go with Lil Tecca. He's the youngest out right now, and he's the best out right now. He's the best doing it at his age, and then... My last one, my third favorite rapper is probably Lil Baby.
Lil Baby's good too.
Yeah, those are my three favorite rappers. But I'm gonna leave y'all to two. I'm gonna go downstairs, see how the Madden tournament is going, and then I'll be back up after a while. So yeah, I'll see y'all boys later. Whoever's watching this, I love y'all. Thank y'all for watching this. Subscribe to the Scott Richards Show. You know what I'm saying, the best podcast out here.
Yeah. All right. What about you, Taeyong? Do you listen to rap?
Yeah, I listen to some rap.
Who you like?
I think Black Bear is very underrated.
I fuck with Black Bear. Yeah, he good.
That music is relatable. Juice WRLD.
RIP.
Rip to him.
Yeah.
What if he's actually fucking dead?
Oh, don't you start
how
that
you fucking
shit.
How you fucking die about a fucking seizure? You know, I'm not gonna get started.
No, I kind of want to talk about it.
Like, think about it. Like, they actually gave no video proof. They just said, boom, he's fucking dead of a fucking seizure.
Dude, he got caught with drugs. This dumbass took him all at one shot and then had a seizure. Obviously, he's gonna have a seizure or something. He's gonna take all those drugs at the same time. Plus, I don't know.
Okay, my third rapper will have to be... Oh, Lil Baby. I fuck with Lil Baby.
Yeah, Lil Baby's good.
Wait, who was your other two?
Black Bear, Juice WRLD, and Lil Baby.
Yes, sir.
Alright, for me, I listen to a lot of rap. I'm more of a heavy metal guy, but I listen to everything. But I think hands down the best rapper in the world, from past to current, is Eminem. Y'all can fight me for it. No one can rap better than that dude. If you try to roast him, your career is over. I like some old rap and today's rap as well. For example, for old rap, I like Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg. Today's rap, I don't like Chapo. I started listening to him. He's good. Juice WRLD's good, R.I.P. Who else? I like DaBaby a little bit, but didn't he get arrested?
He's out now, though.
Yeah, he's out. Wait, what happened?
I think it was a battery charge.
Yeah. Oof. Didn't, like, YG get arrested, too, or something?
YG's a fucking... He's a mess, bro.
So, who's YG? I don't know who that is.
Dated Kalani.
Isn't that Yo Gotti?
No. Yo Gotti's the one who made Down in the DMs.
Going down in the DMs. Yeah, going down in the... Now.
YG made, fucking,
YG made Big Bank,
My nigga. That's a banger.
I don't know. I really listen to a lot of rap, but there's a few I like.
Let's do other genres. Let's do like rock. I listen to a little bit of rock. Okay.
Yo, my favorite band right now is Motionless.
All in Reverse is lit.
Yo, I freaking love you. Yes. Yo. Yo. Ronnie is hands down the best heavy metal singer out right now. Dude is on fire. Popular Monster is an awesome song.
Another good band is Slipknot. Their album that dropped.
Hold on, yo, I listen to Slipknot.
Yeah, like
I'm
versatile. Like that's one thing about me is like I'll adjust to something. Like
I feel
like
I listen to everything.
All cultures need to be like recognized. Like the rap game needs to be recognized. The
Lil Papa's game molested by a dog over here.
He's like licking my bag.
We're having difficulties over here. Rip.
I listen to other shit too.
Don't you listen to Linkin Park? R.I.P.
Yeah, I listen to Linkin Park, probably like Avenged Sevenfold type shit.
Okay.
I do. I have checked out Falling Reverse. They're good.
You know what's a really good band? Mm-hmm. You guys ever heard of I Prevail?
I've heard of them, but I don't listen.
Yo. They made a remake on Taylor Swift. I think it was Blank Space.
I listened to that.
Yo, oh my god. That shit is fire.
It really is. It's better than the original version.
I fuck with some pop shit too.
Old you guys remember Jesse J? I was listening to her today.
No.
What do you mean? No.
Yeah, talking about Big Bang.
Yeah, bang, bang.
Yeah, well, like, Nicki and all that shit.
Who remembers Kesha?
Kesha, she died.
No. Are you for real?
No, her career died.
One hit wonder. What?
She made a couple hits.
Until like later 2018, it just
ended. Yeah. Remember? Oh my god. But right now, my favorite band. What's back to bands? My favorite band out right now is probably Motionless and White. I've been listening to them a while lately.
Falling in Reverse or Slipknot.
Yo, Falling in Reverse. Oh my god. You know the lead singer's Dane Page?
Yeah, I know that.
So, alright, so, any more things you want to bring about rap? Like, anything in the rap world going on?
Just fuck with me, you know.
Didn't, somebody made a diss on 6ix9ine, I think, a few months ago.
Nah,
Was that Trippie Redd or something?
Yeah, Trippie Redd did, and, like, fucking, well, like, the game kind of dissed him, too. Like, I flowed with the game.
Alright, so, I don't know what happened to 6ix9ine. I know he's a horrible rapper, my opinion.
The worst mobile rapper ever.
Oof.
I flowed with 6ix9ine, though, but not, like, too much anymore.
Yeah. That way I first heard him, like, what kind of My Little Pony shit is this?
Also, if you guys don't know, there's genre bending, like, trap metal. It's, like, heavy metal and trap. I fuck with that shit, too. Like,
for real?
Yeah, Zillikami.
Oh, okay.
I fuck with that shit. Like, I love that. I think that shit's good.
All right, Lil Papa, I think you know some rappers at your school. You new people want to give a shout out real quick?
Oh, yeah, Poppy Flacco. But he graduated, like, when I was...
But isn't that your boy?
Yeah, bro, I fuck with that man so much.
Is there any other Rochester rappers you want to give a shout out to?
Yeah, my boy Tyrek the Go. I fuck with that man so much. Lil Perko, Guap Gumbo. If you're watching this, bro, I know your brother.
I know your brother.
David Mason, that's my boy. I fuck with that boy so much. Just my guy right there.
Alright, but back to Juice WRLD for a little second. You really think Juice WRLD's still alive? Day Young.
Some people think X is still alive.
Oh my god.
No, he literally got shot.
Yeah, it was over the news. Yeah. Yo, X was good.
He really was.
Yeah. Like, really good.
That dude, besides just rap, can do other things, too.
Right. Yeah. Him screaming, like, with him. Didn't he make a song with Kanye before? He was, like, screamo in it?
No, that song, it has him screaming over it 1 minute with, like, it was, like, Travis Barker and Kanye West. That shit was good.
Oh, okay. See, guys, I don't know. I don't really know about a lot of rap, so I get all my info from Lil Papa.
Yeah, and,
And Dae Young, of course.
Word.
Word.
Boy, Dae Young, I fuck with him.
What's good?
What's good in
the What's good in
My boy, you know, my boy, Scott, you know.
Scott Richards.
Yeah, even though I don't really fuck with wrestling that much, but when he did, I kind of fucked with it.
Yeah, we don't talk about the EBW's dead.
Yeah.
It's dead. Yeah. Speaking of EBW, we're going to talk about that for a little bit. Dae Young, is there any, now EBW's like over, dead, is there anything you want to like release of any like behind the scenes shit? Like, how much of a struggle was EBW? And it was a lot of struggle.
It was a lot of struggle, especially
filming.
The filming was a struggle. The, you know,
because the camera always died.
Right, and getting there like right on time, and like
everybody trying to stay focused. But it was fun. You and me had a good match.
Right,
we had a crowd that day too.
Right, we did.
And then my grandpa got involved, which was not even planned. Dude, that match got so many views though. I know that was my last one, but that was by far my best match in the backyard, but SW's dead.
We love that.
Do you remember when the time we wrestled in the snow?
Yeah, I remember that.
Remember when I was going to be on that shit? That
yeah.
I was like, you know, shout out to my boy Jamal, man.
Big fella.
I fuck with that man heavy.
Big fella.
Big fella. What's going on, big fella?
You know, if we're talking about EBW, you know, gotta give it to my boy. That's the top one. I gotta give it to my boy Dae Young.
Yeah, alright, speaking of shout-outs, I gotta give a shout-out to the man who was in my new intro. He is one hell of a suit wrestler. He is one member of the UPW tag team Defiance. He is also a trainer at Flower City Wrestling Academy. It is my man, the man in the hour, the GOAT, Chris Kanan. Go check him out. He has a podcast. He also has a YouTube channel. I'll leave his channel in the link description below. Go check him out. He is one of the coolest people in the wrestling world that I've met ever since training pro. Speaking of pro, Daniel, what's your ass going pro? I'm waiting for you. We got to get that rematch because last match, I beat you.
I gotta get my priorities straight.
Yeah.
So, like, that's why I gotta get the grind going, so.
Bitch, I'm grinding.
So, like, I'm thinking about going pro one of these days.
Yeah, and I'm gonna fight you. We're gonna have a rematch. No grandpa this time.
Word.
You know, shout out my cousin, Luke. That's my boy right there.
Luke.
Speaking
of Luke, can we talk about Brody Lee for a minute? Brody, a.k.a. Luke Harper.
Oh, yes.
Dude, a lot of people think he's going to AEW.
Could be possible.
I kind of want to talk about AEW a little bit. Don't get me wrong. AEW is doing really good, but this might be shocking. I'm more of an NXT guy.
Yeah, same here.
But you know AEW is coming to Rochester in 2 months. And your boy is going AEW.
I'm not.
Yeah, I know.
You're
too cool for wrestling, Holmes.
No, I'm not too cool.
Get your rich ass out of here.
I just fuck with the.
Yeah. But, AEW's doing good, but it's got some problems. Not like big problems like WWE, rip. What do you think about AEW right now, Dae Young?
It's doing okay, but, like, I'm not all up. I'm not into the product as I was before when the hype was it.
Yeah.
Was, like, starting up.
In the beginning, it was really good, and then it's the same thing over.
Like, the only problem I had was, like, Cody Rhodes not putting over Darby Allin. And, like.
That is some bullshit. Darby Allin's. Well, they're kind of putting him over, but at the same time, he's losing. They put him in big matches, but right. he's losing.
But make him look weak, like. And I didn't like that because, you know...
Dude, Darby Allin's my favorite right now.
Because he's really is a favorite and has potential. Like, I literally said this on Twitter, and this, like, one fan said, oh, well, if Darby Allin wins, fans are gonna fucking bitch about it.
We're not. Like everybody loves Darby.
Right. Allin. That's what I said. Like everybody loves fucking Darby. Why would somebody bitch about it? Mad people wanted Darby Allin to fucking win. Like.
Remember when he fought Jericho and he lost? I think the building like booed Jericho out of the building.
Yeah.
But Jericho is legit the GOAT.
Yeah, he is legit the fucking GOAT. Even though his hairline is fucking receiving.
Oh, don't you start that shit. Don't diss Chris Jericho.
I love him, though.
Yo, did you see this past week's episode when everyone was singing his entrance when he came out?
Oh, on the cruise?
Yo, that episode was lit as fuck.
I gotta watch that.
Shit like that, like, on the cruise, is so good. Like, okay, you all come Raw and SmackDown feels like overproduct. It's like, that's how, I'm not saying all the time, but sometimes AEW feels like that. Because all the shit they have, like, for TV. But shit like when they're on the cruise, it feels like, I don't want to say the indies. It's better than the indies, but at the same time, it's not overproduct like WWE.
Right.
So I feel like they should do more shows like that, like on the cruise or something like that. And I want to talk about one other wrestling company, Ring of Honor. Ooh, that shit is dead.
Yeah, it's completely fucking dead.
I think it died when... No, it was still alive after the Elite left, I think.
I gotta go check.
You can go. All right, Lil Papa gonna be right back. But, yeah, so, what do you think made, Ring of Honor die?
I think because they lost their, like, top stars.
Yeah.
And, like,
the only they lost a lot.
Yeah, like, the only top stars they have is Jay Lethal.
Marty.
Marty Scurll.
Flip Gordon.
And that's basically fucking it. They don't have, like, all the megastars, like, you know, like... They don't have star power anymore.
I think Marty got control of creative for Ring of Honor.
Yeah, he does.
That's a good idea.
It really is.
Because you saw speaking of Nick Aldis, NWA is doing so good. They're on fire. They're doing really good right now. They've been on a roll.
It has a classic vibe to it. That's what I like. It's like, it brings you back to the old days of wrestling. Like,
I know. So good.
Like,
You know who I really like in NWA?
What?
Thunder Rosa.
Me too.
Dude, she's so good. She really talented.
A really good heel.
Oh, did you see their pay-per-view they had Friday?
I haven't. That's why I've been trying to look for every link to watch it.
But can, like, I spoil it?
What?
I want to spoil one thing.
Oh,
I know
Thunder Rosa beat Selena Kyle for the championship.
Yeah, I was going to give a warning, but some people, I don't know. If you haven't watched NWA pay-per-view...
Oh, fuck. I'm sorry, my bad.
It's all good. Yeah, that's the only thing I'm going to spoil.
Yeah, that's the only
thing. It was a really good pay-per-view. A lot of shocking things. There's some few things I didn't like, but most of it was really good. Better than I thought it was going to be.
Right.
I love what they're doing with Nick Aldis, and I can't believe he went against Flip Gordon, out of all people. And then, I'm afraid I got so bad news. Wade Barrett, True Bennett, your boy... At NWA, because they fired a certain Cornette. Jim Cornette.
Racist Cornette.
Oh. Yo, everybody hates Jim Cornette. Do you remember the time he got into a fight with Santino at the airport?
Whoa.
Jim Cornette got into a fight with Santino Marella at the airport.
Seriously?
Yeah, it's all over YouTube. There's a video.
I didn't even know.
If you don't know what that is, go look up Jim Cornette fight Santino Marella at airport. I don't know if it's still on YouTube, but there's a leak, and those two fought, and, that man, she's crazy. It was the most random fight ever. I'm like, why is Jim Cornette fighting Santino? Out of all people.
I mean, it's always angry.
Yeah. So, I know that NXT and AEW is going to war right now. Well, I don't want to say war.
It doesn't feel like
In the beginning, it did.
Like, they always have less viewers and always stay, like, solid viewers. And it just
NXT's goes. Pay-per-views are really good.
They really are.
But doesn't, like, AEW going to have 4 pay-per-views a year?
I think so.
That's what I heard. I'm not on that for sure. Don't quote me on that. But,
But you know who's controlling it? Tony Khan. I think that's the name.
That dude's a genius. That dude, he's smart.
Right.
But, he's not Vince McMahon.
I think there's a lot of memes about him.
Who, Vince McMahon is a meme. Yeah. I love the memes. I just, every day, just go on Twitter. Oh, there's another Vince McMahon meme.
Actually, you should go on Reddit.com.
Yo, I love Reddit.
Fucking WWE memes. Yo, you ever seen that shit?
That shit is hilarious.
I've been on that shit. That shit is funny as hell, dude.
But, I feel like right now, NXT is doing, I don't want to say a lot better, but they're doing a little bit better than AEW. But AEW just started, so.
Yeah.
Give them some time. Give them some time. I like both, because, I'm an NXT guy, because all my wrestlers are on there. You got Adam Cole, baby. You got Pete Dunne. You got Keith Lee. You got the Valentine Dream, which a certain somebody's a huge fan of.
Hello.
Yeah. You guys don't know this? Dae Young loves the Dream, baby. He loves the Dream. Valentine Dream, baby.
I think he's actually returning in the summer, right?
Some people think he's going to show up at the Royal Rumble.
I think so. I hope so. Fucking miss that guy.
I know you're going
to. It just doesn't feel the same when he's not there at NXT. It's like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It just doesn't feel the same.
You know who I think should come back to NXT? Ricochet. You want to join in? All right, so I know this is going to sound crazy, guys, but we got somebody else join our podcast as well. We've been on here for like 35 minutes so far. He's been on this on this YouTube one time. I did an interview with him last year in the summer with him and the Icon. We got the Mountain Dew Man.
Mountain Dew?
He goes sliding your girl's DMs.
Some Mountain Dew?
He got a thick nose. I'm kidding. He's got a nice mustache, not gonna lie.
Recently shaved.
Yeah. We got the myth, the legend, the sensitive nipple man, Damian Saint.
Who's got a better mustache?
I'm not kidding. He's got the most sensitive nipples in the locker room. What up, Damian Saint?
What's good?
What is up? I am glad to be on this podcast now. Fill me in. What are we talking about?
We're just talking about, the fuck are we talking about? Oh, Valentine Dream. Yeah. How much he's like a huge mark for Valentine. And, who do you think's gonna win the men's Royal Rumble tomorrow night?
It's actually a tie. I feel like Drew McIntyre might win it, but then again, I also have my slow hopes that Aleister Black will.
Why is everybody saying Aleister?
Because Aleister is a
guy. You gotta think about if
Did
you're
in. Did you see the 2 5-star matches he put on with Buddy Murphy and Pete Dunne? Those were fucking late. The match he did
Wait,
with.
Wait, back up. He had a match with Pete Dunne?
Yeah.
When?
It was a few pay-per-views ago, I believe. But
wait, Aleister versus Pete Dunne?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yes. I watched it. And then the match he did with Buddy Murphy at a recent pay-per-view, in my opinion, out of that whole pay-per-view, that was the best match. And he fought that whole match with a broken nose. He deserves
wait,
a push.
Wait, are you talking about Adam Cole versus Pete Dunne?
No, I'm talking about Aleister Black.
Oh, Aleister Black versus Buddy Murphy?
Yeah, that's the match I'm talking about right now.
Oh, Buddy Murphy, I can't believe he joined with Rollins. AOP is a joke.
I think Seth Rollins is overrated.
A new Batman game?
Who do you think is going to win the women's one?
I'm not really a big fan of the women's division. Not sexist.
NXT's got good at women's
not
division.
Not sexist at all, but I feel like if a girl was going to win...
Oh, no.
The Royal Rumble.
Oh, no.
I feel like it
you
would
just
be
pissed off
the NXT women. Not Rhea Ripley, the other one. The other big one. Shayna Baszler. I feel like she might win the women's Royal Rumble.
I'm saying Sasha Banks.
I don't think she deserves
it. So, Damian Saint, what do you currently do right now? I know you got YouTube. You do some backyard. You want to give some shout-outs real quick?
I do backyard wrestling for RSBW. I probably should go pro. Probably won't, though, because
yeah,
I'm stupid.
I'm waiting for you.
But I do make music on my YouTube channel. I play guitar.
Yeah. It's kind of hot.
Yeah.
I did check out one of your songs. It was pretty good. It was pretty funny.
Yeah. Thank you.
Want to give one shout out your YouTube channel real quick?
My YouTube channel is HBTV, space between the B and the T, all capitals with exclamation point at the end.
Yeah, subscribe to this man. Maybe I'll leave you a link in the description.
That would be pretty cool.
Maybe. You have to earn it, though.
I'm at 175 subscribers, you know?
Yeah, shut your ass up. I got 106.
Honestly, the grind was real, because like a year ago, I was at like 36.
Shit. Dude, how long have you been on YouTube for?
3 years.
Same.
My first year I started, it was just a joke, and I didn't really take it seriously. I started taking it seriously last year, a bunch of self-promotion, and actually learning how to play an instrument boosted up my YouTube to what it is right now. I also have a Facebook page, which is at 256 followers.
Dang. I remember when I first did YouTube, I just did, like, skits. I didn't even match. It was just skits with some one of my friends dressed up as Scream. I don't know why. It's such... We took it as a joke. We weren't being serious, but it has so many views. It's like 100 views.
Speaking of... talking about how I did YouTube, that was garbage.
That was a long time ago.
That's because I did it because my cousin did it, and he kind of, like... Well, he recorded it on my phone. It was kind of trash. It was just Black Ops 1 on, like, PS3 gameplay, and then one of them was just, like, that, and it was really bad.
Alright, speaking of YouTube, you want to talk about, EBW?
What about EBW? I mean, I can't really say
you were only on one match.
One pay-per-view, and it was like...
Royal Kingdom.
I don't even remember what entry number it was on.
What happened that day?
My God, it was freezing.
That day sucked.
It was freezing.
Everyone was wearing gloves.
Except me. Like, I was not wearing gloves. I was not... I did not come prepared at all. You know what I came prepared with? I had, like, 3 2-liters of Mountain Dew and, like... 7 bottles.
I am not kidding. This man walks out, bags of Mountain Dew.
I came in with my duffel bag. I set him up all on the rail. I was just like, white out, code red, 2 liter, 2 liter, 2 liter. And I was just like, I came fucking prepared. Little did I know.
To get jobs.
It was freezing.
Yeah.
And at the end, there was this giant brawl, and I ended up getting kicked in the face while getting nae-naed. Totally wasn't expecting it. I was just going
That video's still up. What happened was... Gunner, you Gunner got into it. I look over, you got super kicked. You freaking ate it, and I look at this man, nae-nae.
Reaction, because I wasn't expecting. I was just sitting there doing a nae-nae, and then all I feel is, and then I was just like,
dude.
And then I saw it was such a late sell.
Do you remember when Dark Skirmish chased me and he tripped and fell?
No, he didn't trip. What's his name?
A Lone Wolf Dagger.
Yeah, Dagger. He pushed it, like he kicked him, like. It wasn't a trip. Like he
oh my
him.
God, dude! I miss the backyard days.
Yeah, but
this something would happen to you and King B too. Did you like throw his ass out in the Rumble?
That was the thing. He was supposed to come in, and I was supposed to eliminate him. That is what we planned on doing. But in the car, it was so cramped up in the car trying to get warm. He ended up sitting on my lap, and it was just the weirdest experience ever. Because then Christopher came in, and it was just so packed together. When I say this man's butt cheeks was clenched on my kneecap, it was so weird.
Wow.
It was fun. Other than the fact that
this is how backyard's all about. Yup.
Other than the fact
butt
that
cheeks.
I thought I had frostbite, it was a fun day. Because
I
got little seizures at the end of it.
You lucky ass.
Oh, I didn't pay for it, so it's fine.
Remember when, like...
Mountain Dew to Maui Burst or whatever?
Yeah, it's only a Dollar General's pineapple flavor. It's really good. Yeah.
Do you remember when Gunner launched your ass out of the ring? You almost died.
Oh, hell yeah.
I looked at you, I'm like, I'm care, man. Not trying to freak out. I look over. And I'm like, the fuck was that?
I
look over, you're just dead. And I'm like, oh.
I did not want to get up, but my hands were starting to get cold. So, you know.
Dude, you look like you got knocked the fuck out.
Have you ever seen a white man turn into a lobster? Like, that's how cold it was. Like, I was all red.
Oh, my God. So, you know who Tessa Blanchard is by any chance?
I've heard of her. She's in TNA, right?
Yep, and Impact
like
World
the,
Champion.
She's one of the greatest women wrestlers right now, right?
Did you hear what happened to her?
No.
We were talking about her earlier.
She said like the N-word, I think.
Oh my God, not the N-word.
She said ER.
Yeah, and I think she spit in the person's face, too.
Yep, and spit, and people called her out. And...
Well, I mean, like, you gotta think about it. A bunch of wrestlers have done that. Hulk Hogan did it. Hulk Hogan,
Not Walter.
What's the other, Sullivan?
Lars Sullivan?
Yeah, he said it.
Yo, I heard he got leaked for him being in gay porno.
I don't know if that's true.
It's a picture of him.
I know
Sullivan.
I know he's racist in his past. He used to have like a page, and he was extremely racist.
Speaking of page, Xavier Woods getting that shot. No, that was Brad Maddox getting that shot.
I'm not gonna lie. I did watch it.
You would.
But I didn't like do anything to it. Because I just wanted to see it.
Yeah. And okay.
See,
you want to see that?
All
page?
I see is Brad Maddox sitting there with Paige like this, and Xavier Woods is just zoomed in. Like all I see is the camera zoomed in. I was just like, I can't watch this. This is terrible.
Terrible quality. Did you hear what Triple H said about her?
Yeah,
he's this man. He's talking. He's and the dude asked him about Edge. Can Paige come back? And he's like, but Edge got kids, and Paige probably has something she don't know about. I was like, wow.
But the thing is Paige wasn't even mad about it. It was Paige's boyfriend.
Ronnie, the lead kids. Singer,
fucking love Falling in Reverse.
We were just talking about Falling in Reverse.
Let's talk about them again.
Dude.
Opinions, Popular Monster is their best song out right now.
Thank you. Dude.
Dude, first they dropped Drugs, which went fucking hard.
Slipknot.
And because Corey Taylor's in it, and Corey Taylor's my fucking boyfriend, okay? Like, if I was a girl, Corey Taylor would make me wet. Like, he makes me wet now. Like, honestly. Yo. But, no. Drugs came out, and nobody told them to go that hard. And then all of a sudden, they come out Popular Monster. Like, who hurt them that to the point where they had to spit so much? Like, that song is beautiful to me. That shit gets me pumped
up. He goes from rapping to singing to screaming.
Dude, I love the fucking high note he hits in that. It's so...
Dude.
I don't listen to him.
Ronnie Radke.
But...
He's been so high lately.
But, like, Falling in Reverse did change a lot.
Do you remember the old band he was in before we went to jail for a few years?
No.
Escape the Fate?
I didn't...
Wait.
I didn't really...
That wasn't the band.
I didn't really listen to much Falling in Reverse until, like, recently.
Situation.
So I'm kind of a fake fan, because the first song I listened to by them is Chemical Prisoner.
Oh, no.
And I kind of like that one. And then, moving on, I didn't really listen to them that much. I listened to all of their albums, like, recently.
Have you heard of...
And my favorite song by them right now is Popular Monster, but my favorite song by them in general is their cover of Gangster's Paradise.
Gangster's Paradise. Dude, that is a good cover.
Mm-hmm.
There's this, oh my god.
My
this
favorite
is
part
funny.
Of the song is where Coolio, the original singer, is like, oh, in the whole.
Oh, oh.
That's the funniest shit ever.
Oh my god. So, yeah, Falling in Reverse, dude, they were gonna be here. And
yeah,
then,
I was gonna go, and then they
canceled. Me too.
I was kind of glad they canceled it, because I ended up going to
you know
a
who's,
local show.
You know, who's doing really good right now, too? Motionless and White.
I was supposed to go see them, but they changed the prices of tickets last second, and I didn't have enough for it. I was gonna go see Motionless.
Dude, they are red hot right now.
Alice Cooper, Motionless, and White, Hailstorm. I was gonna go see, and then
dude, I fucking love Hailstorm.
I'm not really a big fan.
What?
I only know like one song by them, and that's I Miss the Misery, only because it's in Rock Band.
Yeah.
Oh, Rock Band. I remember those days. I remember just shredding on to get
the AEW or NXT.
NXT. I'm sorry, AEW is kind of sloppy. They got all the talent in the world. I'm not
lying. Dude, they need to push Darby out.
It's not even that. Like, I've watched a few. It's just sloppy. Like, if you think WWE, they plan it out.
WWE's overproduct.
Yeah, they overproduce their shows on WWE, but they don't produce their shows enough on AEW, in my opinion. Like, you go out there, and it's just like, with Dean Ambrose or John Moxley.
Jad Moxley!
So you see John Moxley and Chris Jericho, and it's just like, you got the people backstage. You got the people backstage who are just like, you and you are going to fight. Just go out there and fight. It's kind of like how they do in the backyard. You just go out there and just wrestle.
Oh, my God.
There's
not much
scripting.
Yo.
You got to agree with me on that. It is kind of sloppy. Do you know how many botches there's been in AEW? Like, Cody Rhodes botched a front flip.
No, remember that punching botch that went, some guy that dressed up as the guy from the Dark Order was punching Dustin Rhodes and completely kept missing the entire time.
It's just sloppy. I feel like they don't produce their show enough, and WWE overproduces.
And NXT's so, like red hot right
NXT's
now.
NXT's like right in the middle. It's just like,
it's just perfect. Their women's division. The only thing they need to fix is their tag team division.
As much as I hate to say this, Triple H is actually a really good runner of NXT.
Why you gotta hate to say that? I love
Triple
H. I
really don't like Triple H that much. I used to, but then.
Why? Because he roasted Paige?
No, because he's just used so much. He's kind of a John Cena, in my opinion.
Oof.
Just used too much. Like, when he came back and
won, I low key miss John
when
Cena.
He won the Royal Rumble coming out entrant 30 to beat Roman Reigns,
that
shit had me
a big
pissed.
Meme.
I thought it was kind of lit, to be honest.
Triple H buries talent. He buried Dean Ambrose. He buried a bunch of people. Like, think
he didn't
about
really
it.
Bury Ambrose.
Well, in that Royal Rumble, nobody
Vince
wanted Triple
did.
H. Nobody fucking wanted Triple H to win. Let's be honest. Dean Ambrose was on fire, and then then Triple H is just like, nah, fuck you, and then just threw him out. Like...
Yo, do you know that day? That was my birthday that day? And AJ Styles debuted on my birthday, baby!
My favorite wrestler at the time retired on my birthday.
Who?
Daniel Bryan.
He's back!
He did his retirement speech on my birthday, and I was just like... But then Shane McMahon returned, so it was kind of a win-win at the time.
So how long do you think you're going to do Backyard for?
I'm 16 right now. I'm really only doing it because I got nothing fucking better to do.
I'm 18.
Go pro, dude!
I have no life.
Go.
I just recently quit my job, so I'm probably going to be doing this a lot more than I want to.
Where did you used to work at?
A piece of shit hotel. Do not stay at the Residence Inn in Henrietta on Jefferson.
Wow. Shout out Rip.
Do not stay there. I would not recommend it. Why? I gave that shit half a star. Like,
it was trash.
The people that work there are shit. The hotel is nice because I used to fucking clean it. So
I got a question for you.
Yes.
Do you have any funny backyard wrestling stories to share? RSPW, RUW, EBW.
Alright, so I'm gonna
And you
tell
can
you
be
guys,
PG or rated R.
No. I'm gonna tell you guys one of the funniest moments in my opinion, and it doesn't involve me. It involves my dad at the time. This was a triple threat match in the first ever RUW pay-per-view. This was before we met you. So we were recording this on Facebook Live. It was me versus Christopher in a match, and it was a triple threat between Christian Cross, Nightcrawler, and my dad. I forgot his name. I don't remember his wrestling name.
I don't remember it.
He changed it, and I don't remember it. But okay. He was...
Wait, your dad wrestled?
Yeah, it was only for like...
Oh, word?
Fucking boomer. But... So, it was planned where Miguel, or Dark Scorpion, and JCR Core attacked my dad, and he ended up getting RKO'd through a table. So, that happened. And then the triple threat happened. And it was Christian Cross standing ring, and I kid you not, he RKO'd my dad in the middle of the ring. He got up, was like, yeah, looked over at me while I'm recording and doing music and said this, am I supposed to win? Out loud, and we had a crowd there too. So it was like a crowd of maybe like 7 people, including kids and parents.
Oh my God.
All you hear is Christian Cross get up and just be like, am I supposed to win? And I was just like,
you stupid motherfucker.
I was just like, tell me he did not. I am Booker T that shit. Tell me he did not just say that. Like, it's
wow.
That was by far one of the funniest, like, non-dangerous moments. But I'd say one of the funniest, like, dangerous moments is where I kept getting thrown into the garage. Like, they would throw me and I would, like, try to break the garage. Like, constantly getting thrown into it. Like, but... Other than that, me and Dae Young also did a False Count Anywhere match. We also went in the house.
I was there that day.
We got in here, and I ended up doing a Falcon Arrow on JC Hardcore's bed. And I was just like, his room is as dirty as his fighting style, and I did it. We ended up breaking his bed because right here you can feel it goes in. Yeah. When I Falcon Arrowed him, you can hear in the video the wood snapping in the box, and you can see it in my face. I did it. I was just like, time to end this early. Boom. I looked at the camera. I was just like, oh. And then I pinned him. And I was just like, we're not going to tell him I broke his bed. We ended up telling him we broke his bed. But it obviously doesn't affect
him. What was
him.
His reaction?
He's like, you fucking assholes. Like, I wasn't expecting this shit to happen.
Do you watch Ring of Honor, New Japan, NWA? What are they?
I can tell you that I do not. I'm not really a follower of wrestling. I mean, I know most of WWE and some AEW.
Oh, you're just a WWE guy?
Yeah. But I don't even watch.
Do you know anyone in New Japan? Currently?
Is Kenny Omega still there?
He's an AEW, you dumbass.
I don't watch that.
What about Ospreay? Will Ospreay?
Is he
still there?
Yeah.
Okay, see? Dude,
he's good.
See? I know my...
Yo, everyone loves Ospreay.
Because him and Ricochet put on that one amazing match in NJPW.
I think Ricochet is just a little bit better than him.
I don't know. That one match, the reversal was in the beginning. It was like 5 minutes.
Didn't Vader shit on that match?
Who's Vader? Darth Vader?
Darth Vader?
Did you just...
Darth Vader?
You mean Big Van Vader? The fat...
It's Tom! It's Vader Tom! R.I.P.
The fat bald dude in the red suit. Yeah.
He passed away a few years ago.
Yeah, the fat version of Kane.
Hey, don't you start dissing Kane.
I thought you were talking about Darth Vader.
No, Cap, you said Vader in the first episode. Darth Vader? Why the fuck would Darth Vader shit on NJPW?
Darth Vader's a wrestler now?
Vader just goes up to everybody and they're like, I am your father. Just starts choking everyone. Like, his choke slam is he just stands on the other side of the ring and chokes.
Oh my God.
And then he pulls out his lightsaber.
That sounds like some shit AEW would do.
That's a perfect fucking character right there.
Yeah.
Anybody uses that, it's my idea. I said it first.
Yeah. No, he pulls out a lightsaber too.
Pulls out a lightsaber and I join the dark side, Luke.
Yeah. Yo, imagine then Kylo Ren comes out of nowhere.
I have a weird ass laugh, so everyone that's laughing right now, you have every right to laugh.
Just Kylo Ren comes out, the girl, where is she?
Kylo Ren kills his father on stage.
Yeah.
The good.
Yes. We're losing on topic here.
You mentioned it. You brought up Darth Vader.
I was talking about Vader the wrestler, you dumbass.
Nerd.
What?
Darth Vader.
Here he comes. Darth Vader just goes like,
do it.
Or Emperor Palpatine,
do it.
Just sits in the corner.
Do it.
Sits in the fucking corner.
What the fuck?
Do it.
Just, oh my god.
So shocking.
Yo,
for my first episode podcast, this is going to get a lot of views.
So, speaking of Star Wars, did y'all watch the new one?
Yeah. No, nope, do not.
Oh, I want to spoil it so bad.
Bro, it's so good.
The ending had me like shook when that happened. Such a shame I can't tell you.
It was between you and me.
Plus, some people that listen to this might have not seen it.
Yeah, like
that. But the ending had me shook, though. Like, yeah. I was not expecting that.
Alright. Do you want to join in now?
Sure.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome JC Hardon.
All I gotta say is, Roman Reigns has a big dick.
Yeah, JC's gay, you guys didn't know that.
You don't call him big dog for nothing.
Anyways,
I bet you his name's
you guys want to talk about Star Wars for a minute?
Yeah, but we can't talk about
it. Whoa, all right.
Spoil it.
Besides the new movie, what's your favorite Star Wars movie?
My favorite Star
Revenge of the Sith.
Bro, that's hard.
I agree.
Thank you.
Return of the Jedi.
I'd say the one where Anakin got turned into Darth Vader.
That's Revenge of the Sith.
I don't know their names. Jesus Christ.
Revenge of the Sith.
Yeah,
towards the like that in the movie when you got fucking
dude,
Colorado.
This podcast was going on for 55 minutes.
Most podcasts are like an hour.
Hour podcast.
Yeah,
like, yeah. Who's gonna listen to an hour podcast?
Not. I used to listen to the Misfits
podcast.
This shit's
hilarious.
Yeah, those guys are fucking.
I know my dad's gonna listen to this.
What the Joe Rogan podcast?
all he does is smoke.
What supercat?
Elon Musk.
What?
Anyways. I think we should probably wrap this up here. Is there anything else you guys want to talk about? We got like a few minutes left to spare. JC, you got any funny backyard wrestling stories to tell? If you had to tell one funny backyard wrestling story to tell right now.
One funny backyard
Man of Steel.
Oh, yeah.
Tell him.
Basically what happened was there was a spot we were doing in a practice match.
Explain what you're talking about.
So,
Balls of Steel.
It was me and... Did you name him Damien or Hunter?
Damien Saint.
Damien, okay.
Oh, rip.
Damien Saint. Me and him were
in a practice. He knows who I am.
It was during a match or a practice match?
No, it was practice. We were doing it in practice.
Yeah, so we're practicing his new finisher, which is basically the Apollo Crews.
It was
Crews.
A pop-up powerbomb, but instead
no,
of...
No, it was the Apollo Crews one.
Whatever.
Why is it Balls of Steel or whatever?
So basically what happened was he went to go powerbomb me down... And he went face first into my nutsack.
No, this man's balls hit my chin so hard. Like, when I tell you that shit hurt. This man's got nuts of steel, bro.
Nuts of steel. Nuts.
It didn't even hurt him, though. That's what pissed me off. He wasn't fazed by it. And I basically ate this man's nuts.
Oh my god.
His nuts hit my fucking chin so hard I look like a rooster. Actually more like a cock.
Yeah.
He made a penis joke.
Yes.
Penis joke.
Cock. Cause rooster.
Alright, I got one more question. We're gonna wrap it up here. Do you guys think Juice WRLD is still alive?
No.
Yeah. You know who thinks he's still alive? Jay Young.
I don't want to talk about this.
Come on. Share your feelings with the group.
I don't like Juice WRLD.
Alright, after this, we're going to kill him.
Honestly,
why?
People call him a legend. He's not a legend.
I don't want to say legend, but he was good.
Like 3 years. Like, relevant for 3 years. He's probably famous before that, but think about it.
Yeah.
No, his first song was Lucid Dreams, right?
All Girls Are the Same kind of blew him up, and then like.
But think about it, people like what did they do with X? They compared him to people like Biggie, and like when he died, everybody said it was the saddest day in hip hop history. Like, come on now, you can't.
Yeah.
When Tupac died, when Biggie died,
dude, the saddest day is. Wait, who's your favorite rapper, Damien Saint?
My favorite rapper,
Mine's Eminem.
No, I'd have to say Eminem. I
don't like all right, let's go. Fellini hanging.
I'd say Eminem's new album was fucking trash.
Godzilla, Godzilla's his best song.
His he broke the a world album record.
He
only,
did.
The only good song there was Godzilla. Every other song was
he broke a world record.
All right,
he tried to bring Slim Shady back and he failed epically.
After this, we're gonna kill JC.
But no, back
to was garbage.
Back to what I was saying.
Yeah, well, Nick Cannon diss was fucking ass. His fucking diss towards fucking Nicki Minaj was ass. All his disses and that whole album was ass.
Speaking of Nicki Minaj, ass.
Straight back for I'm an Eminem fan, die hard.
If I want to game one,
die for that nigga. But it was trash, horrible.
We're not gonna talk.
If anyone heard that, please comment yes. If you're still with us right now,
no. When X died, my phone was spammed with it, and that was annoying. Like, he really didn't do much. If you think about all the bad things he did, like, he beat up his pregnant girlfriend. He did all these bad things, and people consider him a legend. When 6ix9ine got arrested, a lot of people said he was a legend. And
dude, 6ix9ine's ass.
He's freaking trash. Like,
he's a snitch.
Yeehaw McDonald's a better rapper.
Yo, I love Yeehaw McDonald. He's hot.
Swear to God. And when Juice WRLD died, I was like, think about it. You're on a plane landing somewhere, and you have illegal weapons.
The cops found them.
Illegal ammo, and
a lot of drugs. He took them all at the same time.
You had a bunch of drugs, and then you took it all at once. Yeah. Like, you weren't gonna die if you got arrested. But I understand why he killed
himself. The drug in me is you.
I understand why he killed himself, but then again, like,
if anyone got that reference, you're awesome.
Point. Like, I got the references.
Yeah.
Falling in reverse.
Alright, we're going to wrap it up here. It has officially been 1 hour we've been doing this podcast. I can't believe we actually did for an hour. I'd like to thank everyone that was on this podcast. Little Papa, Damien Saint, JC Hardcore Faggot, The Icon.
Fucking Balls of Steel.
And Day Young, those two fuckers left. But everyone, thank you for listening to the first episode of The Scott Richards Podcast on the YouTube channel, The Scott Richards Show. And everyone, please don't forget to super kick the like button. Super kick the share button. Always leave a positive comment below. And super kick!
Suck my dick.
The subscribe button if you're new here. And
if you don't, I'll cook you chicken. And I'm white, so I can't cook chicken. So you better fucking do it.
And everyone have a great day.